In this module, we're going to talk about application services in Azure and how to auto-scale with those. There's been some recent updates to our UI as well as some of the features that we have in auto-scale. So I thought it'd be good to kind of step back and think about what actually is auto-scale trying to do for us, what can and it can't do it for us, and what the UI looks like for how to control this and configure this in Azure. I'm going to cut to a PowerPoint here and just show you briefly, this is what we'd be looking to achieve. So in this case, we have, and we're just going to use artificial names here, but we'll say we have three instances of a web app running here, right? And what we're looking to do is basically scale this out so we can create more instances. So right now, maybe we have three instances running, so all of our traffic's coming in here. It's being load balanced across this entire cluster that we have here. And the idea is to be able to scale and be able to create more over here. Sorry, we'll call that three. And over here, we would create web four. So we can continue to add instances. And what this is called scaling out as opposed to scaling up. When we take a look at the portal, I'll show you the difference between those two. But essentially, what we're saying is we're not going to scale the CPU and the memory and that kind of thing with this application. We're actually going to create more instances of it. And as long as our application can handle that, typically a stateless type application can handle that very well. It gets added to the load balancer, and we actually can spread the load over more instances and achieve scale out for our application. So if we pop over to our portal, in the portal, and we're in the new portal here. This is our current gen portal, not the the one that's been retired now or is kind of being sunset is the manage.azure.com. You'll notice we are at portal.azure.com. Clear distinction just to make sure you're on the right portal. When you're in the portal, on the left here, we have this nice selector. And one of the things that's there by default is app services. Now, I've stood up a web application here. And the thing to remember about app services is it's not just app service is basically encompassing a service plan that we're going to have, which basically means how big is the machine that we're going to run this on. And then inside of there, we can create web applications, mobile applications, and API type applications. So I have a website that's already stood up here, a web application. And you can see that my service plan, if we zoom in on that real quick, you can see right here is my service plan. And you can see I'm under a standard SKU right now. Important distinction. So when you come in here, settings should open by default. But if it doesn't, you just click on the settings button. And what happens is if we scroll down here to this section, right here for the app service plan, so basically we can configure and change our app service plan on the fly. So if we didn't like what we've provisioned it under originally, or maybe we need to make it larger, like we do want to scale the CPU up, we can come in here and take a look at what the metrics are, how our site's performing. But more importantly, if we hit the scale up option right here, you can see we get all the SKUs here. So we actually have right here's our premium tier. And then we have a standard tier here. And then down at the bottom, we actually have a basic tier, which doesn't do auto scaling. And you can tell right here, I'll actually zoom in so you can see that. But like you can see, it says up to three instances manual scale. So in this case, we can't automatically do it. We could do it manually. These other offerings from standard and premium tiers actually give us the ability to do auto scale. So you'll notice that we don't scale up. So we don't scale between standard and premium. That's something you would decide beforehand. We do scale out. So when we click on the scale out option here, you can see that we do have some options. I have one set up here right now, but we'll create some more here. You can see that we're scaling by CPU percentage. And in my case, I just set it arbitrarily to 59%. So if my average CPU is 59% or more, we're going to go ahead and scale up. And we can actually drag this slider to say how big do we want it to go. So how many more instances do we want to create? 3, 4, 5, and we can go up to 10 here. We can do all kinds of different things with the scaling if we actually change this option. So right here, you can see we can do it manually. And this would be something for the basic tier, or if you don't want to do auto-scaling, you can come in here and manually do that by yourself or through the API. You can also scale by CPU, which is what I just showed you. You can also do one that kind of does both. So in this case, you can see that I have some settings in here for CPU that's going to increase and decrease instance counts. But we can also click on this add profile here. What's interesting here is we can create things for like weekday, let's say. So let's say during the weekend, maybe we don't receive a lot of load, but this is a line of business type application, and we know Monday through Friday is when we actually want this stuff to happen. So in that case, we can actually come in and pick the days that we want this to apply. So not only are we scaling by CPU, but we can also scale by days or by a specific fixed date range. So we have a reoccurrence here that says, let's do it every Monday through Friday. If we wanted to do that, we could do something like that. We can also schedule the times, and then we can do a fixed date too. If we said we just want to scale it between these times, maybe we're doing a new release and we actually want to expose and have this thing really performant while this thing is being launched, because we know there's going to be a huge influx of users using the site. So in that case, we would set something like a special case there. And we could have multiple of these in here. And you'll notice in the portal, we can also, if I go ahead and cancel this, you'll notice that we can also do emails on the scale actions. So this is part of our alerting system inside Azure to not only allow you to do auto-scaling, but it also allows you to email and notify people like administrators or co-admins so that they're aware of what charges are being happening here, how big the thing is actually scaling, so they can keep track of that. One other thing I wanted to show you is when you saw in the UI, we set up the CPU. We actually have another way to kind of come in there. So once you have these settings set up, you can hit this add role. Let me just circle that so you can see it. It doesn't look like a hyperlink, but if you click on that, you'll get this little scale rule slide out over here. And then here, you can actually select a lot more. So you can select not just CPU, we can also select memory, disk queue lengths, all kinds of different things. And these will change, you know, according to that. So we can basically set our thresholds of high and low. And you'll notice that we can actually set a cooldown as well, which is interesting because scaling is an interesting animal, because when we actually do auto scaling, it's not just as simple as saying, hey, when you see the CPU hit 70%, go ahead and scale up. That would be a horrible scaling metric, because basically sometimes if you've looked at a system, the CPU could spike there for a second or two, and you don't want to be triggering it to scale up and scale down really quickly. That would actually cause disruption in the service. And so you need to kind of govern that, or kind of even that flow out a little bit, so we're not scaling up and down so rapidly. And that's what this cooldown allows you to kind of tweak. And so that completes the module on app services and how to use the new auto-scaling features in the portal to scale your app services.